हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर यूट्यूब चैनल बाय ज्ञानमंजरी मॉडर्न स्कूल। टुडेज अवर वीडियो इज फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 9th सब्जेक्ट साइंस एंड अवर करंट चैप्टर इज चैप्टर नंबर 10 ग्रेविटेशन। इन दिस चैप्टर, इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव लर्न अबाउट व्हाट इज ग्रेविटेशन एंड इट इज़ अ जस्ट अ फोर्स विच अट्रैक्ट्स ईच अदर। ऑल्सो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द यूनिवर्सल लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन। व्हाट इज द यूनिवर्सल लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन? So universal law of gravitation means that any two object in the universe is having that force, they attract each other by a force. And what is the proportion of this force? What is the quantity of this force? So the quantity of this force is directly proportional to the product of the masses of two objects, and also it is inversely proportional to the distance between the square of the distance between them. And this distance is calculated from the centers of the two objects if the force is along the line between the centers of two objects, means line between the joining the centers of two objects. So all these things we have discussed in previous video. Now here again today we will derive the formula for universal law of gravitation, means capital G. Also we have discussed this thing. Here I have written the universal law of gravitation. Every object in the universe attract other object with a force, means any two object. I have given you the example of the duster and the pen. So they are also having the force of attraction between them. And what is the quantity of that force? How much the force is there? Why they are not attracting each other? Why they are falling on the earth only? And also I have given you the reason, because that force of attraction of the earth, gravitational force, is many more times more than the gravitational force of the two objects. Means both are falling on the earth. They are on the earth because they are binded by the gravitational force of the earth. So if there is a gravitation, there is a force of attraction between two objects, what is the quantity of that force? So which is proportional to, means directly proportional to, the product of their masses, and inversely proportional means inversely proportional the square of the distance between them. Also I have explained what is the meaning of direct proportion or the only proportional, and what is the meaning of inversely proportional. If one quantity increases, other also increases, is called direct proportion. And if one quantity increases, other quantity decreases, it is called inverse proportion. And this the square of the distance between them, if the objects are away from each other, force of attraction is definitely less. And if the masses are more, the force of attraction is more. In short, this is the thing which given in the universal law of gravitation. So this is the definition of universal law of gravitation. Students, again note down this. Again and again you have to write this, very important, and also it is easy to understand. Just note down it. I am giving you 1 minute. Okay, now we will derive the formula. Suppose there are two objects here, object A and object B. The figure is given in your book. Nothing is new, students. Two objects are there, object A and object B. So objects are not always the sphere, a spherical shape, but here we are taking as a spherical. It is given in your textbook. These are the centers, and this is the distance between two centers. Suppose the distance is d meter, and the mass of this object is mkg, capital mkg, and mass of this is small mkg. And distance is in meter. Units are very essential here. So we will start with our derivation. If it is asked in exam, state and derive. So what is the meaning of state? Means you have to write first this definition, very important. Also this definition is given in your textbook. And derivation means we are going to derive in the on the board. So derivation, let A, object A, A with mass mkg and object B with mass small mkg. The distance between two objects let the distance between two objects is d meter. So this is our supposition. There are two objects, object A, this is object B, and mass of object A is mkg, mass of object B is small mkg. The distance between their centers is d meter. This is we have just taken to derive the universal law of gravitation. Okay, now we will start with our derivation, students. What is given here? Force. So here also we can write, let F Newton is the force of attraction between two objects. So three statements, let. First let was for masses, second let for the distance, and third let for the force of attraction between them. Now we will start our derivation. What is given here? This force is proportional to, means according to universal law of gravitation, F is directly proportional to the product of the masses, means M into M. So this is the sign for direct proportion. What the other thing is given? Inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So F inversely proportional means not 1 upon inverse proportion. Just write the sign same, but here it is 1 upon d square. So force of attraction between two objects is directly proportional to the product of their masses, and force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between two objects. Suppose this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Combining equation 1 and 2, what we get? F is directly proportional to mm upon d square. So here we can say F, when we convert proportional sign into is equal to sign, there should be constant of proportionality. G is equal to mm upon d square. Here G is constant of proportionality. Very easy students, very easy derivation, can be asked for 4 marks. Also the law is very easy to remember. Just first equation, F is directly proportional to the product of their masses. F is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. When we combine these two equations, we are getting F is directly proportional to the M and inversely proportional to the d square. So here this and this we can write in the numerator, in the denominator d square is there. If we convert this sign into is equal to sign, there should be the constant of proportionality, and here the capital G is the constant of proportionality. Just note down this student, then we will go further. I am giving you 2 minutes. Okay, now we can write this equation in a different form. What is the last equation we got here? It is F. We got here F is equal to G M upon d square. So here we can write this d square come on this side. So F into d square upon, it is in the numerator, when it comes on this side goes in the denominator, and what remains here? Just the g. Therefore we can say g is equal to F d square upon mm. So when once we know the formula, if other quantities are given, we can find any quantity. If the values of these and these are given and distance between them is given, so we can find the force of attraction between two objects. It can be between the earth and the moon also, it can be between the sun and earth also, between the star and planet. So any type of force of attraction between two objects can be calculated with the help of that formula. And to find the value of G, which is a constant of proportionality, G is equal to FD square mm. Now here we can say that the force of attraction of any object in comparison with Earth is negligible. So students, when we have to find out the value of constant of proportionality and we consider the earth and the moon, then the mass of the earth, mass of the moon and distance between them, and we can find the value of G, and also it is calculated by the scientists, and value of G is given here on the page number 134. The value of G was found out by Henry Cavendish. He was a great scientist, Henry Cavendish. The value of G was found by Henry Cavendish. Also, the year is given 1731 to 1810. Between this year, by using the sensitive balance, and accepted value of G is Now, what is the value of G? Is equal to 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11. And what is the unit of this? To find the unit is very important. Now, how can we decide the unit of any quantity? Now, we know the value of G is equal to formula F d square upon mm. Now, what is the unit of F? That is Newton. So, we can write here Newton. What is the unit of distance? The unit of distance is meter. We have taken while drawing the figure. So, it is meter, but here it is square, so meter square upon mass. There are two masses. This is kg, kg, so it is kg square. So, this is the unit of universal constant of gravitation. This unit can also be written as Newton meter square kg raised to minus 2. In this way, it is given in your textbook. So, if it is written in the denominator, just kg square. When this kg is written in the numerator, it is kg raised to minus 2. Because when quantity comes from numerator to denominator, its indices means in power changes, means sign of the power changes. And from denominator, it comes in the numerator, again the sign of power changes. So, here we are having the value of G 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11. For all sums, you have to remember this value. G is equal to 6.67. You can write up to 2 digit, and this is more perfect. Into 10 raised to minus 11 Newton meter square kg raised to minus 2, or Newton meter square upon kg square. Just note down this. Now, then we will proceed further. Student, also remember the name of the scientist Henry Cavendish can be asked for the MCQs or in the true false FB. So the name of the scientists are very important, and the value of G was given by the scientist Henry Cavendish, and it is 6.673 into 10 raised to minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. Now, our next topic is importance of this law. What is the importance of this law? Importance of universal law of gravitation. Where this law help us? What is the advantage of this force? So, it is given in your textbook, students. The force that binds us to the earth. Force that binds us to the earth. What is the meaning of this? So, due to this force only, we are on the earth. We can stand, we can walk, we can run on the earth. If there is no force of like this, So we are moving anywhere. Suppose there is a no force in the universe. So it is very difficult for the astronaut to move in the space. So it is very difficult for them. So this force is very useful, very having its own benefit. Number two, the motion of the moon around the earth. Motion of the moon around the earth. This is also possible due to this force. So due to the force of attraction of the earth on the moon revolves around the earth. And also same for the all the planets, they move around the sun. So due to this force only, this phenomenon is possible. And also the seasons and day and night, everything is possible due to this. Now third, the motion of the planet around the sun. As I told you, the gravitational force of the earth is many more times than the moon, and gravitational force of the sun is many more times more than the earth. So due to this gravitational force, planets can revolve around the sun, satellites can revolve around the planets. And the fourth one, tides due to the moon and the sun. Tides. Due to the moon and the sun. Students, you know what is tide? In Gujarati, we can say bharti and ot. In the ocean, we can see tides and ebbs. So these are due to the force of attraction on the moon. On full moon day, there is, we can see the tides are there. And on other day, there are ebbs. Means these due to this force of attraction, these tides and ebbs are possible. So these are four advantages, or we can say importance of the universal law of gravitation. So students, this much is enough for today. Now the time for homework. State and derive universal law of gravitation. And secondly, write importance of universal law of gravitation. Okay, so this much is your homework for today. Just note down your homework. Bye, take care.